In this video, I want to go ahead and take a look at the new trail renderer that we get with Unity 5.5. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new object. Let's just go ahead and create a cube. And I'm going to collapse everything. I'm going to go ahead and make sure it's at 000. I'm going to go ahead and collapse everything. And we'll go ahead and add the new trail renderer. And let's go ahead and take a look at it. So just like the previous one, we have the ability to cast shadows if we want. We can go ahead and turn it off. We can also receive shadows. Now motion vectors, we can go ahead and set it to either use the camera option or have its own, or completely turn it off if we want none at all. Materials we'll look at in a second. I want to go ahead and cover some of these other ones before we come back to materials. If you have any light map parameters set up in your scene, you can go ahead and add those. And time, let's go ahead and take a look at time. Make sure I got a good view of my object here. So as we go ahead and move our object around in the scene, this trail renderer is made up of all these different segments, and each one is going to last 5 seconds. After that 5 seconds, it's going to go ahead and get rid of it. Let's go ahead and lower this down to 2 seconds, so it's not quite as long. And I'm going to grab it and just move it more fluently so there's no pauses. And we notice it just keeps coming along with us. Now, if you have this set to a fairly long time and your game object that the trail renderer is attached to is moving quite quickly, you can end up with a really super long trail renderer. If that's what you want, great. If not, keep in mind, the smaller the time value, which again is in seconds, the shorter the trail will be. Now, the minimum distance between these vertices is by default 0.01. So as it's moving along, you can't really see the vertices. In the old version, you could. I wish you could go back to that. But you could actually see where all the different vertices were. Now, auto destruct. If we go ahead and hit play, I'm just going to hit auto destruct on. And as I move my game object around, notice how it's drawing the trail renderer for me. Now, if it ever completely runs out of trail renderer, it's going to go ahead and not only destroy the trail renderer itself, but destroy the game object it's attached to. Now, I don't remember it having that behavior in previous versions of Unity. I thought it just got rid of the trail renderer itself. Go ahead and let me know down below in the comments if I'm wrong, if it actually did destroy the game object itself. It's something I'm going to have to go back and take a look at. But either way, I'm fine with this behavior as long as I know about it up front. So the width property works just like it did before. If we go ahead and make a trail renderer and we go ahead and play with the width, it just makes it thicker or thinner. I'm going to go ahead and set that back to 1. But the really cool thing now is we have this graph down here where we can go ahead and you can right click anywhere on it, add a key. Go ahead and move it down, make it thinner, play around with the bezier curve on it. Maybe we want it to start thinner, get thicker. No, start it off thicker. Let's actually really bring this up. Let's go 3. I'm going to drag this out a bit. So see that really big thick part? Starts off at 3, goes down super low. Let's add another one. Let's curve it this way. Let's move it up a bit. This is it shrinking. So as you can see here, you can go ahead and get pretty creative with the actual sizes, with the actual shape of your curves, and the overall trail renderer in general. Color, we'll go ahead, we'll take a look at after we've gone ahead and added a texture to it. And let's go ahead, we'll make a longer one here. And let's add a turn to it. We're gonna need more room. So I'm just going to zoom out this way, zip up. And I guess really we should go ahead and have this be flat again. So if you right click any one of these points, you can go ahead and delete them or play around with some of the other options on them. I'm going to go ahead and delete these just because I want it to be nice and flat. There we go. So we have this trail renderer. And if we go ahead and add more vertices to the corner, take note here of the change that's going to occur. And it looks like we're going to need a longer one. So anyway, we'll get a much smoother corner with more vertices to it. And we take them back out. There we go. And the same thing for the end caps. Notice how flat this is, how square it is. We can round those out as well. There we go. Now, I don't know if it's a bug or supposed to be some new feature, but after a certain amount of time, which I think might actually be tied to the time here, every time we click in here, it removes a segment. That also goes when we're typing. It's a little bit annoying. I don't know how I feel about it right now. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead, round those corners a bit more. There we go. Now, the alignment works just like it does with the line renderer. By default, it's set to view, which is the camera's view. We can also go ahead and set it to local, which is going to be the actual view that you get according to the actual transform itself. So take note of that. I'll go ahead and set it back to a view. And if you have light probes and reflection probes in your scene, you can actually go ahead and take advantage of those as well now. So let's go make that material. I'm going to go ahead, create a material. I'm just going to call it trail, short for trail renderer. And make sure that you're on one of the particles. I'm just going to go with the additive for now. I'll select my cube where my trail renderer is. I'm going to go ahead and drag it into element zero. And now let's go ahead. We'll drag one out. You can actually click on the color. Oh, is there anything else? No, it looks like the first one's color. And we're going to get the gradient editor. Now, this bottom row is for changing colors, and the top row is for alphas. So let's start off in the bottom. How do you change these? You always know which one's selected because it has that slight blue outline on it. And you can go ahead and select one and click the color down here to change it. As you can see, I have a few down here. We'll look at those in just a second. So let's go ahead. I'll pick that. Let's take this one here, and you can either double click it or click once and then click the color down here. I'm going to take a blue, and I didn't do it. There we go. And you can click anywhere along these lines here to get a new, well, I call them crayons, but a new tab. You also have the eyedropper, so you can actually come out and grab a color. Whatever your mouse is over, you're going to get. Let's see if we can get that red. There we go. And let's go ahead and take a look at the alpha. Oh, well, one more thing is you can actually go ahead and move these around too, depending on the shifting and the weighting you want. And you can go ahead and make one more. I'm going to make a white one. There we go. So for the alpha, we can go ahead and just select one. And then we get the alpha slider down here. We can just go ahead and change that and see how the transparency opens up. You can also move where that transparency is going to take effect. And if you notice there, I accidentally clicked off. I lost it. Let's say you dragged one off and you completely lost it. You can, again, just click anywhere you want, drag it in. Of course, you'll have to reset the values for it. Now let's take a look at the mode. Right now, we're just blending from one color to the next, nice and even. We can also do fixed, which is going to be blocks of color. So if you want some more blue, whoops, I did not want that one, so we'll just drag it off. You can drag in some blue. There we go, we got blocks. I'm actually going to stick with blend. And move back this way a bit more. And let's come down to these presets. So let's say I've got this set up. I really like this and how it works, and I know I'm going to want to use it over and over again. I can click on the new, and it goes ahead and saves it. And of course, I can select any of these other ones, and it'll go ahead and update that as well. And let's say I don't want these anymore. I can right click and delete, or even move it to first or replace them. So let's go ahead and we'll take that one. And let's go ahead and start moving this around. And there we go. We got our nice little rainbow going. And there's a couple other things we should look at here. What else do we have? For the texture mode, by default, it's set to stretch. So whatever texture you have assigned to this material, it's going to stretch that over the whole trail renderer. Now, I do not have one assigned, so I'm going to grab something with a little bit of alpha here. I'm going to grab this one here. Make it a little wispy. I'll come back to my cube, and I want to make some more lines here. I'm going to bring the end cap down to 1 and maybe a 3, so we get a little bit. That's really wispy. I think I made it too much alpha. For demonstration purposes, I'm just going to go ahead and crank this back up. Let's leave it at full. There we go. And we'll switch from stretch to tiled. And as we see here, for the tile, it just goes ahead and takes that material and tiles it along the way. So whatever effect you're looking for. But that's it. That's pretty much all there is to the new trail renderer. What do you think about it? Let me know down below in the comments. Do you like it? Do you like the old one better? Again, we're not really losing anything. The main difference is really is now we can go ahead and set some sort of bezier curve for the width. And I think in the last one, weren't we restricted to something like 4 or 5 colors? Now we can set as many as we want. We have that new gradient tool. Either way, I like the changes. Let me know down below what you think of them. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. So if you like the video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. It really does help me out here on YouTube. And go ahead and follow me on Twitter. You'd be a pretty chatty guy over there. when I'm not walking through a forest or being stalked by eagles and falcons, lions, tigers, and bears.